لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا رب سواه
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلاة وسلاما على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا ونبينا محمد بن عبد الله الصادق الأمين. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله سيد الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين. أحمدك ربي على كل قضائك وجميع قدرك، حمد الرضا بحكمك لليقين بحكمتك، وأصلي وأسلم على خير خلقك ونور عرشك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على أشرف الخلق وحبيب الحق المصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Brothers and sisters in Islam, respective viewers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and ahlan wa sahlan, and welcome to our program. First of all, we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, may Allah make it easy for all our students, those who are writing exam, may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala grant them a good result, inshallah. May Allah use them to serve Deen al-Islam, inshallah. And we make dua to Allah, may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala accept the dua of the ummah to the entire Muslimin. May Allah accept the dua of Imam al-Haram to the Muslim Ummah. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, may Allah make it easy for us to fulfill the haqq of Allah and the right of Deen Islam, inshallah. Brother and sister in Islam, our program today, it's a message to all our young boys and girls and those who want to achieve something in this dunya. I think all of us, if you ask every person, you will find ourselves is jazua halua. We are impatient. We feel that we did not fulfill or did not receive our luck and our taqdeer in this dunya. Every person is jazua halua, and everyone is complaining his taqdeer, and everyone is not happy with what we achieved. You find many boys study so many years. You say, Sheikh, you know, got how many degree, and I study so long and I don't get a job. Another one, he said, Sheikh, my daughter, very good girl, reading Salah, never have a boyfriend and never get any haram, but no boy come to propose. And you find that person, he said, I work hard, I eat halal, I try to get halal income, but I don't know, my children are not salih. And you got here in front of me so many complain that people said, things are not coming right. I try to open a business, never work. I try to get this, never work. I don't know, Sheikh. I used to make salah and I never done that to my parents. Why my children like this? Why I'm unlucky? So you find these people, they don't make sabrun jameel. They got something is called jaza. Oh, he become jazua and halua, impatient, and he got a lack of sabr. I want to tell my friends, we are human being and we are insan, but Allah put us on this way just to remind you and to remind ourselves. We have to understand that Adam alayhi salam, our father Adam alayhi salam, came to this dunya not for holiday, or it was a reward from Allah. It was a punishment. It was a discipline for him. And this dunya here is Daru Ibtila, is a place of test and temptation from Allah. So you must know that you are the creation of Ibtila. Allah wants to put you in this way so that we can get the best of you, or the top of your amal. Why we say that? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala put test for every creation of Allah. You find some animals, leave the babies, animals, not insan, not children of Adam. What do you think about that? It's unfair. And that baby, you feel sorry for that small chicken or that small goat or that cow or that dog. And you say, Allahu Akbar, how this one is going to survive? And these animals are living with us. What about the animal in the jungle when the mother being killed, or the bird in the nest? So you find that dunya, this life here, is a dunya of ibtila, temptation. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا أمنا وهم لا يفتنون. This ayah is very clear message from Allah that Allah will never let you and I claim and assume that you got iman without giving you a test. Many of the children, they say, I'm good in the school, I'm the best in the class. All right, you can say as you like, exam will show, exam will show. So you find every Muslim facing exam after exam, it's called Tathir, Tamhis, the name of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They call him Al-Mutamahis. What is Mutamahis? Is the one who went through many difficulties and came up from it with full mark. From the time of birth, he lost his father, mother, difficulties in his childhood. Then he became Nabi, faced his family, faced the people of the book, faced the idol worshiper, faced his own tribe, his own uncle, and then pass, they call him Al-Mutamahis. So Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam shows us how to be min al-mukhlisin. What is mukhlisin? Those who are striving to purify themselves. Brother and sister in Islam, you can turn that test to ibadah, to the test of Allah. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did say in the hadith, man mata wa hajatahu fi sadri. Anyone who died, well, he got some desire or some need in his heart. And I think, wallahi, so many of us, they did not achieve what they're planning for. Many of us, people wish to have money to spend. People wish to have knowledge to teach people. Many children, they want to pass on the school, they want to get a job, they want to marry. Many of the girls want to marry and have a babies and nice family and nice house. And you got some people with working hard just to make a house, who to live halal, and he died before that. Many sick people, they wish to have cure and remedy, and they die sick. So Allah Tabaraka said, whosoever die while his need in his chest, never complain, never done haram to fulfill that need, he will become Malik min Muluk al Jannah. He will become a king of the kings of Jannah. Brother and sister in Islam, you got two types of need. The desire one, the haram one, and the halal one. So our body needs food. We don't have food, so you don't go and steal. You hold. The man needs women, but he doesn't marry. He hold and wait. That's why even the desire, it's called the need of haram. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala count that person when he suppressed that need, suppressed this desire for Allah. Man taraka shay'an lillah, awwadahu Allahu khayran min. Whosoever left something for the pleasure of Allah, for the sake of Allah, Allah will compensate him with something better than it. And ask those people who try this, and you try it one time. Many people, they used to have a bad habit. Can't survive without a cigarette, can't survive without the drugs or without zina. And this person, he left that bad attitude for the sake of Almighty Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. And it's not so long Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala comes with his izzat and his jalal and entertain that person and give him something. He got the same pleasure like this one, and Allah recompensate that person with something better than what he left it for the sake of Allah. Many people left their home, left some money, or left some dispute, and Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, all of us, we leave it, but not for Allah. We have to readjust that leaving. You leave it, lillah. We leave it because my father won a fight. We leave it because my lawyer, we're going to have ask for so much money. No, I want to leave it for Allah. Leave it for Allah, for the sake of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. So whenever that demand or that need become more in your heart, and the more holding you have, Allah will reward you, and you will have that we call extra recompensation of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. I want to tell you something, that many people join Islam, and then that person in kufr time before Islam used to do everything. Used to drink, used to have a girlfriend, used to have fun. There was nothing, it's called haram and halal for him. His dunya was Jannah. And that person decided to say, you know what, I am joining. I have to leave that for Allah. I must follow that. Look at this person and ask him. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala change, as I always say, change his software. That he will never, you see this person here in South Africa who accepted Islam, can't believe. See, this boy here, is this boy here South African? Yeah. Mother is like this, father like this? Yeah. This man is more keen to practice deen than the children born in Makkah. And we feel shy that how come this is a sheikh? One day, I was teaching the children, African children, and then I was reading the hadith that isbaghul wudu ala al makarih, when you make wudu, while you dislike it, oh, it was very cold and no hot water, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala loves and he will give you double reward. So I taught this hadith to the African children, and then I forgot. So that young boy, about 9 years or 10 years, I don't know after how long, he tell me, Sheikh, salam alaikum, it's too cold today. I tell him, yes. He said, did you make wudu today? I said, yes. How you make it? I said, no, I open the heater, and then the geyser, and then I make wudu with the hot water. He said, oh, Sheikh, where's isbaghul wudu ala al-makarih? This boy surprised me with that, and I said, Ya Allah, I'm being caught today with that little boy here. He said, Sheikh, Allah loves us to make a little bit of sacrifice to admire and to enjoy the wudu from that cold water as long as it won't kill you. I said, Subhanallah, these children just accepted Islam? No. And he took the deen of Allah with quwwa, the power, and this is the real taqwa. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala compensate each and everyone who sacrificed his desire and his haram demand for the pleasure of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. They ask me to stop for a short break. We'll continue after the break.
La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brother and sister in Islam. And once again, we thank you that you're tuning to our program. On behalf of all our boys behind the camera, my sound engineer, my cameraman, my studio manager, and all our friends here, we say shukran jazeelan that you're tuning to our ITV. May Allah make it easy for all of us, inshallah. And may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala grant us recompensation. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala grant us that recovery of all what we have missed in our life, in dunya and akhirah, inshallah. Before the break, I was talking about how Allah tabarak wa ta'ala recompensate the people after iman and after accepting Islam. And not only that little boy who was correcting me and was advising me, you got so many Muslim, new Muslim. We don't say Muslim or new Muslim. We say those people who gained Islam after they lost it, and we find them are more strict than, you know, the Muslim in Europe and America and some non-Muslim country. They stick with deen more than the Middle East one, or more than those people who are born next to the haram. Why? Because he was so worried to abuse deen of Islam, and he want to recover, and he want to cover up what he has lost. Brother and sister Islam, why Allah tabarak wa ta'ala promised the person who changed his religion and come to deen of Islam that Allah will delete and Allah will wipe all his previous sin? That is also is called iwad, recompensation. Because this person, it's not easy for him to decide to move from that faith and that church or that belief to take him to other belief. And not only that, you want to cancel all his deeds and cancel all his bad habit, and you want to let him come on a sirat al-mustaqim. So you tell him, don't drink, you mustn't have a girlfriend, you must marry, you eat halal, you must eat slaughtered one, and all this command of Allah. And this person said, sami'na wa ata'na. So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is so happy with that person because he sacrificed taraka lillah. He left it for the sake of Allah. So what is the compensation? What is the payment for that person? All his sin forgiving is better than me and you, because he made a great decision and Allah gave him a great reward. At-tawbatu tajubbu ma qablaha. The person who repent to Allah, not never mind that non-Muslim and you become Muslim, me and you. You had a bad habit and you decided to leave it. That girl got a habit that she don't put a scarf. for so many years, she's not used to have the scarf. And then suddenly this girl took the piece of cloth and tried to cover her head. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala forgive her for the past. Why? Because she sacrificed lillah. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave her the best recompensation is that your sin is forgiving. Plus Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will give you the payment. Come and see the payment. Number one, it's called al-uns billah. Uns billah, it's to have a company of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. You know, you read the ayah, inna Allah ma'a sabirin, inna Allah ma'a al-muttaqeen. You find this word like that. So something it's called al-uns billah, to have the entertainment from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. You just leave that type of haram, leave that thing there, just go to Allah. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will entertain you. They call it al-uns billah, or the company of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And we did see. I met one man, he was a singer, a musician from Europe. And then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave him uwad. He left that hobby and he became a da'i and a scholar, caller to Allah. So I told him, you don't miss that keyboard and that music and all that. He said, no. I don't miss it, because once I make that decision, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave me the Quran, and I don't have a time for that one. Allah changed that hobby and that habit from haram to halal, and he become a best reciter of the Kitab of Allah and listening to the Kitab of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So they call it iwad from Allah, or recompensation from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. The other thing also, Allah give that person payment, they call it itmi'nanul qalb, tranquility on the heart. So you find this lady, after she bought the scarf, that you see the woman naked on the TV, on a wedding, or this, doesn't affect her at all. You say, oh, nice, come on, I'm okay, I'm very happy. Or that person, after he give up the drugs, or alcoholic, or any type of haram, you see people say, no, I'm okay. And you find you got too much itmi'nan, and ya ayyatuha an-nafsul mutma'innah. What is mutma'innah? Nothing irritating it. Very cool, very peaceful nafs. You got to call it itmi'nan. Ala bi dhikrillahi tatma'innul qulub. No hasad, no jealous, no malice, no hesitation, no doubt, no shirk. Very, very peaceful person. What a nice person when he got itmi'nan. Ala bi dhikrillahi تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. Another reward of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he gave it to the ummah, that husnul khatima. You decided to leave that haram, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said, this person here, he deprived himself from some thought of pleasure for my sake, is for me, so I will let him die in a beautiful way. And we see some women die on sajda, some women die on haram, some people die in the hand of alim, or in the hand of a good family to make dua for her on a good day, a good time, good place, so in a good condition. Allah tabarak will give them a beautiful khatim, husnul khatima. They become nur in their grave. Another thing, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, immediately after you give up that type of sin or that type of habit, Allah will let you forget about it. Forget about it. And we see it on the month of Ramadan. Many of our boys and girls, they like food. If the wife delayed food for 10 minutes, he fight. And he can't. If you break time, lunch time, like this, he go. In the month of Ramadan, is khalas. You go there, pass many takeaway shops, and then you see the food there in the kitchen, is forget about it. No, I'll eat it. I will eat it after Maghrib, inshallah. I'll eat it. So many of Muslims like me and you, we'll do it inshallah yawm al-qiyamah. I don't need it. You find that man, his wife is not so pretty, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala let him forget zina, and his wife is the most pretty woman ever he met in his life, because the barakat of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. They say love is a blind. Yeah, it's true, it's blind, and must be blind. Blind so that this person, he close his eyes for the for the any faulty of this woman, just see the good. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And we see in our life the old men and young old women, they're living with each other. I don't know, they love each other for what? For what? It's called muhabba. Muhabba. He want that lady on his life. So that is called the reward of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So what type of act you have to leave immediately? Number one, you must leave the chakwa, they call it impatience, or to stop complaining the taqdeer of Allah. That I can tell you from the bottom of my heart, if you want to gain that recompensation of Allah, the itmi'nan, the tranquility, leave that complaint of qadr of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Especially that taqdeer or that destiny which Allah wrote it for you. What is the taqdeer? Just say, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raja'un. You got sickness, you got loss of money, you got some problem there. Just say, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raja'un. Once you say, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raja'un, that you don't oppose the taqdeer of Allah, because this thing is going. You like it or not, it's going. Your son passed away. What are you going to do? He won't come back. So what you do, just quickly accept that taqdeer, even with your mental, never mind with your heart, with your aql, with your mind. Allah, my son is gone, what must I do? So once you say, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, look at the ayah what he said, ulaika alayhim salawatum min rabbihim wa rahmah. Immediately you gain a recompensation. It's called salatum min Allah. You know, inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. So Allah and angels are praising Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and blessing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You will get the same. Once you say inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, you find the salat of Allah and the angels, ka'ulaika alayhim salawatum min rabbihim. Allah Rabbul Izzat from the seven heaven, mentioning your name, praising you, wa rahmah, and the mercy of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will come to you, and that person who died, or the mercy come to you when you have that loss, or when you have that disaster in your life. When we say rahmat of Allah, the ulama gave us a nice explanation. Rahmat of Allah, Allah will let you react, or your reaction so easy. In the time of funeral, you see this lady crying heavy, and this one here, she's sitting and talking and she's normal. Women say, this lady loved the marhum so much, this one here is shaitan, she don't love him. She don't cry. No, it's the rahmat of Allah. Allah placed that rahmah like this. Oh, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will lightening that feeling on your heart. This person is saying, subhanallah, when my husband died, I used to stand up and meet people and I talk and I look after the children. I went to the funeral and I brought the body and we have handled the life. You see, this lady, and then later on, maybe after one month or two, she started to cry, say, I was drunk or what? You say, no, is Allah lightening the musibah till you handle it? And you see, many people who are in an accident, someone want to rob them, from where the power come? It's Allah tabarak wa ta'ala assess them on that and that reaction. Another thing also which Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, we could say they give him a basira. What is basira? Right decision in a time of disaster. They call it basira. What is basira? A common sense. Certain react, you do it in the correct way. You will never be hesitated to have a decision in that time of calamity, on the time of disaster. May Allah save us inshallah and grant us basira inshallah. Short break, will continue after the break.
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brothers and sisters in Islam, and once again we say jazakallah that you're watching our program, and shukran jazilan for all our friends who send the SMS and made the phone calls. And may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala use all of us to serve his deen. May Allah grant us better understanding of deen Islam inshallah. Today I'm talking about how you sacrifice for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and how you make that great decision and also realistic decision and very wise decision to sacrifice that haram, and you come back to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and you wait for the payment of Allah or the return of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to you, or that عوض من ترك شيئا لله عوضه الله خيرا منه. Whosoever left something for the sake of Allah, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala will recompensate that person and grant him better than it also from Allah, not from the abd. Another thing also, before the break I was talking about how can you invest on the time of calamity. When you say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, ulaika alayhim salawatum min rabbihim wa rahmah, wa ulaika humul muhtadun. Allah give you hidayah and basira, as I said before the break. The other thing you have to leave also, which is very hard for me and you, but we try, recall it, you're not running for dunya in such an ugly way, the way we see it every day. You know, I don't want to lie and tell you, no, leave dunya and leave that dunya. No, I don't want. There's no alim, there's no one who can preach and say to the Muslim, you must leave business and must leave your money and leave your farm and leave your job and go to Allah. I don't mean that one. But don't be over on seeking dunya and demanding dunya. You play it small. I see many people, they say, Sheikh, we work for Allah, we want to go this, we get this one. You go to the bank and you take a loan and you try to play it very big. And then you find yourself on debt, you find yourself having a financial problem, you find yourself on the trouble. So play it small. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا ما أتاها. Allah does not put any burden on any soul as long that he got what Allah provided him. So yeah, we have to talk about something. It's called takalub ala dunya, to run after dunya and to compete in this dunya just for competition. But Allah didn't tell you just leave dunya, because kuffar, enemy of Islam, will pick it up and stand against that. But just leave that greed of dunya, and you see, they will come to you min haythu la tahtasib. You know, you say dunya, you run after it, huh? It won't come to you. You leave it, it will come to you. Why is like that? Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, he renounced dunya and dunya ran after him. Sayyidina Abdurrahman bin Auf, he gave up his money two times, his wealth two times. And dunya, he said, wallah, if I pick up the stone, I will find a golden dinar day and a dirham. And it means have that moderation, work normal, give the right of your life, right of dunya, like this. So what I'm trying to say, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will give that person some thought of richness. We like dunya because we want to get some what you call self-sufficient, or some thought of contentment there. That contentment, not because of money or because of what. Nabi Muhammad was asking Allah to give him Aishul Kafaf. What is Kafaf? A sufficient income for the need of dunya to worship Allah. If I get sick, I need money to go to doctor. If I want food, I got money to buy the food for my children and get iffad. If I want to go for hajj, that's called Kafaf. Not to live poor and to struggle. No, Islam doesn't allow us to ask Allah faqr, to be poor or to struggle. So, what we're trying here, that Allah will give that person ghina in the heart. لَيْسَ الْغِنَى عَنْ كَثْرَةِ الْعَرَضِ. Richness, not because you have so many wealthy things or so many property. The ghina is a feeling, I don't need it, so I'm rich. So I don't need it. If you're rich and you need it, you're poor. So that's why we said, my friend, I don't need it. You drive that small car, and then you find someone driving a big one. We wish to have the big one, but I don't follow this car and I try to make hasad and make jealous and say, wow, like this, why Allah you never give me like this? You say, it's fine, but I don't have it, so what must I do? I love my car, I am happy. You live in a small house, very simple house, but I don't have money to buy the big one. And if I buy the big one, it's not waste, it's my capacity. But I don't have jealous for the person who got that big house, who you got many children, I don't have a children like that. So it's called ghina fil qalb, richness in the feeling, or in the contentment in the mind and the heart. And you find the Sahaba, Sayyidina Abdurrahman bin Auf, you know, he was a multi-millionaire. He was a very, very wealthy person. And you find Sayyidina Bilal, and you find Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, for 2 months he never make food. He never started a light in his house. Live with a date and the water. So why we, it's like that. And Sahaba agree, this one is rich, this one is middle class, this one is got kafaf. It's like that. So there's no competition for dunya. And to compete for halal, alhamdulillah, but to harm each other, that's called takalub ala dunya. Another thing, you leave it for the sake of Allah, is something that's called sihr, the black magic. When I say sihr, I mean those people who were trying the means and then they never achieve their goals. So I was in a hospital, I was trying to open the shop, I tried to do this, and then I became a failure. I couldn't achieve. So what you do? One man come to me or to you and tell you, know what? I got jinn can do that for you. See, but I was trying to do the lawful way to be rich, or the lawful way to marry this woman, or the lawful way to get medication and to get cure. But no, I have a superpower besides the power of Allah that it sort out this problem. So now you are confused now. You got that person, he claimed that he's going to give you shifa, and the doctors doesn't give you shifa, and you make dua, you didn't get shifa. So you become in a crossroad. You don't know what to do. In this case here, you need to sacrifice. You need to leave it for the sake of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. You say, Wallahu khayrun wa abqa. I will never get shifa by drinking alcohol. I will never leave Allah and run after jinn and shaitan and iblis to give me some shifa. Even if it comes, that shifa will come. The lady met Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and she said, Oh, the messenger of Allah, inni usra. You know, usra, women in the Arab country, the usra is to fat in the street and then, you know, the body, very hard to see your wife. Lying on the street. And then Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to this lady, if you want, I can make dua for you. Or you make sabr, it means you leave, walakil jannah, you have jannah. I don't know if you are in a place of this woman, what you're going to do. That problem will be solved now by dua, not by the jinn. You never say go to jinn. I will ask Allah to give you shifa from that now. Oh, you got another thing. You leave this one and you will get Jannah. Allah will reward you because she left it for Allah, as we said, sacrifice. Like that person, he left the greed for reward. The compensation. Man taraka shay'an lillah, awwadahu Allahu khayran min. So if she want to leave that thing and go for Allah, Allah give her something better than that. It's called Jannah. So the lady was very clever, intelligent, very wise. She said, I will make sabr. And Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam guarantee for her Jannah, inshallah. Then the lady walked away and she came back and said, Ya Rasulullah, but walakinni atakashaf, my body is exposed. So the lady was not worried about to faint on the street, but she was worried about her iffat, her hijab. And she said, Ya Rasulullah, but my body is exposed. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I will make dua that your body won't be exposed. So Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made dua for her satr. The lady was worried not to fall on the mud, to fall on the water. No, it was worried about her aura. The man will see her aura. The lady used to faint on the street, but her body is covered because of the barakat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You got so many people nowadays. They come and say, I can make for you ta'weez, witchcraft. I can ask that person will double your money. You know how many stories we see it, especially in Africa. Yeah. And then you find that person, he said, but if I go to that man, my daughter will come right and she will get married. Leave it for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Don't get involved on the major sin, sab'ul mubiqat, one of the seven main terrible sin in Islam, which we call sihr. Another thing which is very important, that something you have to leave for the pleasure of Allah, that it's called kadhib, lies. And you know how many hadith talking about lies, and how many hadith describing the sin and the punishment of those who commit the lies. you leave lies. And you see, no, especially those people who think that lies can save them. Nabi Muhammad said, Al-Kadhibu yuhlik. Lies will destroy your life. In dunya and akhirah. No, but sometimes I lie and it went well. Yeah, it went well in dunya, but you know what was happening. You written, indallahi kathaba. You written by Allah, in a good son name, it's called kathaba. So you want to be, instead of calling you Mr. Muhammad al-Mu'min al-Sadiq, Malaika call you every day Muhammad al-Kathib or Ibrahim al-Kathib or Fatima al-Kathiba. No, I don't want the people I don't want myself to be saved from the harm of the people and to put myself in the harm of Akhiran Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. So, Al-Kathibu Yuhlik. Leave the lies. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala will give you Sidq and He will save you from His side. May Allah make it easy for us and write all of us in the eyes of Allah as a Siddiq with Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Short break. We'll continue after the break.
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brother and sister in Islam, and once again we thank you that you tune into our program. And I'd like to give salam to all our viewers from our hometown, Linasia, and shukran jazilan for all our viewers. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala make it easy for us to fulfill the haqq of Allah. And may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala compensate each and everyone who left some pleasure for the sake of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and for the sake of Deenul Islam, inshallah. The other thing we have to leave, which is very important also, that to associate partner on fear. Yes, whom do you fear? I don't know that the lack of yaqeen also is a major sin. So we have fear of Allah, but we don't call the khawf min Allah only. We got khashya. What is khashya? It's better than the khawf. What is khawf? Khawf, you're scared of someone who's going to harm you. But khashya, that fear mixed with respect and love. So those yakhshuna rabbahum, those who fear Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in such a way, it's called khashya. So I want to, do you scared of Allah or you make khashyatullah? And then aynun bakat min khashyatillah. That one eye has drops and tears because of the khashyatullah. So what is khashyatullah? The crook, we don't have khashya for it. We have khawf. You're going to kill me. But your father, when he call you and you run to him, you don't have khawf. You married, you have a children, you stay by your own. But he call you, you respect. It's called little fear with little muhabba and respect, dignity. So you say, you don't raise your voice or you don't stretch your leg in front of your father. Not because he's going to hit you and punish you, because you love him with little bit of fear. So do you have that khashya of Allah, or you fear the other creation of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala? You know Fir'aun, he's the only man who said, Ana Rabbukumul A'la. He's a proper tyrant and dictator, came and he got advantage till he believed himself that he's God, he's Allah. And actually, he asked his prime minister, Haman, to build a tower to go to meet Allah and to fight Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So each and every one who is not believe in Allah, he used to take him as God or to fear him. Now the magician of Musa, Fir'aun, when they met Musa alayhi salam, for that time of competition, who's going to throw the stick? These people came to, with raising hope, that magician, to have something and to get payment from Fir'aun. And then Fir'aun promised them. But when they see the truth of Allah and the miracle of Nabi Musa alayhi salam and the truth of this nubuwat of Musa alayhi salam, they forgot the fear of Fir'aun. 70 magicians, they had a greed. They got desire to have. I just want to tell you how much sacrifice this 70 magician sacrifice. So they left and they tell Fir'aun, "Aqdi ma anta qad. We don't care. Do as you like." Where's the fear? He said, "Ana Rabbukum al-A'la, I'm your exalted God, I'm high God." He said, "I don't care." Once the person got yaqeen and he left it for the sake of Allah, he doesn't care. So اقضي ما أنت قاد, I will kill you. I say, kill. إنما تقضي حياة. You just do whatever you do in this dunya. I don't care. From 70 magician and turning to 70 shaheed. You become a shaheed because they don't have fear besides Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, when you only have that khashya of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, everything will fear you. Everything will respect you. Everything will think about your value before you attack. It's shaitan, jinn, human being, whatever. Brother and sister in Islam, just have khashyat of Allah, an absolute khashyat of Allah, and have that dignity of the fear of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and love of the fear of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, and you will see how much Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will, how much protection Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will give it to you. Other thing we have to leave also is very important, especially our young boys and girls. They call it argument and dispute and chatting. That argument or the dispute. And you know, is a sin of Banu Israel when they have to have argument, to have jidal, to argue with a person looking for the truth. Alhamdulillah, scholars of Islam, they have argument, but they want to find out the result. You have a conference and everyone, you go in the parliament, they have argument to achieve, to improve and develop the country. But what about if that something is called mira? You argue just to defeat that person. Come on talk show, one man and one woman. There's one, you talk like this, this one talk like this. What? For 1 hour fighting and confusing the viewers. And then you say, sorry, our time is up, we'll meet next time. Makes so excited show, but you don't achieve anything. You achieve hatred, you achieve argument, you achieve racism, you achieve stubbornness in the mind of the people. You don't achieve anything. But Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He gave us jidal to reach the truth. That argument to reach the truth. And then two of them must agree. You can't argue and you leave it open like this. No. Me and him, we have to fight, and we argue, and we have a dispute. I give him a proof, he give me proof, till one win. You can't leave it like that. And then that win, I have to follow him, because we got only one copy of haqq. We got only one truth. We don't have different type of truth. So we got something is called mira. Mira, it means useless argument. Leave that useless argument for the sake of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will let the people believe that you were right. Jawabu ma yukrahu sukut. You have a wife, talkative, all day, what, like this. Instead of raising your voice, and wife raise her voice, and the neighbors look from the balcony and from the window, and the children sitting on the corner of the house, and then the father come and mother come, and you find that man is like two chicken are fighting each other. And everyone parking, and the children are crying in the corner of the house. And then the mother sitting there, and the father sit, and everyone raise his voice. And the neighbors, non-Muslim, watching and say, what is that? And then he say, no, one man want to win. And the lady decided to say, no, I don't want to argue, leave him. Leave him, yeah, for the sake of Allah. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will recompensate you. He will cover up that. He will give you the nusrat of Allah. من ترك شيئا لله عوضه الله خيرا منه. You just leave it for جواب ما يكره السكوت. The best answer for something you dislike, just to keep quiet. And how many women, because they kept quiet, the problem is over. But how many women stood up to fight back, or to answer back, or to raise the voice, and end up with talaq, or maybe murdering, or maybe abuse, and the children are crying. So Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I guarantee a place of Jannah for any person who taraka al-mira, it means leave that useless argument, wa huwa muhiq, even if that person was right. You leave it for the sake of peace, for the sake of stability, for the sake of the children, for the sake of Allah, you can do like this. Another thing, which very important, also, we have to remind our young boys and girls and all of us that lowering your gaze. brother and sister in Islam, this eye, that look, very, very big problem. I'm not talking about women or haram. I'm talking about anything. You look at the ni'mat of someone, you make hasad. You look at the car of someone or the house of someone, try to lower your gaze for the sake of Allah. Another al-haram. You just leave it. You know that the compensation or that payment of Allah when you leave that haram, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will give you the noor in the face. This is a glooming face, the bright face, Allah will give it to you. Why? Because you leave that look and Allah will look at you with His noor. The other thing, you will enjoy ibadah. Many of our young boys say, I don't feel my salah. I don't know how to memorize my Quran. I don't enjoy my ibadah. I say, you know what? It's because of the eyes, my friend. Eyes. How come you got a phone and you look at the pictures on that YouTube or that video and you're reading Quran and say, no, I don't know why I don't make... How come you study while you're on the music or you try to backbite someone and you say, no, I can't understand, I don't do well in the school. Brother in Islam, lowering your gaze, controlling your eyes, you will gain something is called the nur, the light on the face. Your face will be bright. And also, Allah will give you that pleasure of ibadah. You will enjoy your salah and ibadah Ramadan. Plus, Allah will give you something you will never get it by anyone else. It's called farasatul aql. You will become genius. You will have senses. You will have that power, intellectual power, that intelligence you have in your heart. Why? Because I don't abuse my faculties. I don't abuse my brain and my heart. Everything is vision, still fresh. So you can think properly, talk properly, and you can work properly and live properly. So you don't have any damage. You do not have any waste on your senses and your qualities. Another thing also, many of the brothers, they think that money can save you from a hard life. And many people like to save money, alhamdulillah. But watch out of saving money, because sometimes it's called bukhul, stinginess. That person, the miser person or misery. Misery is a terrible. You will never accompany Allah in Jannah at all. That Allah made qasam to Jannah, that baqil, that miser person will never enter Jannah. Living like a poor, resurrecting on the day of Qiyamah with the rich people. So he never enjoyed his money, but he must pay for his money on Akhirah. Brother and sister in Islam, once you leave that stinginess, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will grant you hubbun nas, the love of the people, company with Allah in Jannatul Firdaus, and then Allah overlook your mistake. The person who spends for the sake of Allah is sakhi, kareem, and Allah is kareem, so Allah doesn't calculate your sin, the entire sin. He wa ya'fu an kathir, and he overlooks your mistake. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala save us from anything which Allah tabarak wa ta'ala dislike. Oh Allah, make it easy for us to sacrifice and leave that bad habit and bad act for the sake of Allah. And oh Allah, recompensate us, grant us and pay us back something can cover up that what we miss by sacrificing that desire and that habit. My time is up. Unfortunately, inshallah, we're going to continue next time. Shukran jazilan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. رب القلوب وهو علام الغيوب في الشروق وفي الغروب نوره يهدي العصا ربنا الهادي الودود.